Hello everyone. In this episode of Pro Experience Sharing, we have IIT Kharagpur alumni Prigya Arora with us. She has a unique experience of working as an intellectual property rights specialist. So in this episode, you will get to know about her experience of working on that role and more. So please stay with us till the very end if you are interested in making a career in this domain. All right. So before we get started, we are coming up with many such interviews every week. And if you are interested in knowing what exactly top professionals do on day-to-day basis, please subscribe the channel. So now, without further ado, Prigya, thank you for coming in.
Thank you so much, Vijay. Thank you for inviting me.
Yeah.
It's a pleasure being here.
Yeah. So, Prigya, can you tell us a little about yourself and the role or thing that you are currently into?
Correct. So, speaking a little bit about myself, as in the introduction you told, so I did engineering from GPP IIT Pantnagar, and then I did law from IIT Kharagpur, and after that I worked with a law firm for about 3 years and then started off on my own practice. So this is a very different area where we work with inventors, artists, business people, writers, poets. So it is extremely interesting to work with, varied kind of people. So IP is something related to whatever anything new is coming up in the market. It could be in the form of inventions or paintings, music, anything. So it's another art, legal and techno-legal field.
So I'm a little curious, actually. Typically when people are there in their engineering final year, so most of the time they are thinking about maybe getting into an IT company or getting into a core company such as NTPC, ONGC, or any of these companies. So how exactly did you decide upon taking this course? As in, how did you decide after your engineering that this is what you want to do after completing your engineering?
So, there is a small story behind me choosing this field. So when I completed my engineering, my father was undergoing some kind of, he was into some legal hassles. And randomly one day I told him, why shouldn't I do law? Why don't engineers do law? They'll be able to understand these things in a much better way. Though it was not related to technology, but that also was a niche field where, it wasn't easy for lawyers to understand what kind of technicalities are included there. So I was then looking for a law college, and I found that IIT Kharagpur has this course. So I randomly thought of, doing this course and exploring a new field.
Brilliant, very brilliant. So basically, at least my learning here is that maybe, we should have eyes and ears open. When somebody is there into, let's say, law or in patents, doesn't necessarily mean that he has to be there or she has to be there thinking about it. Oh, when I am oriented towards law, then only I can do it. So there is an aspect of it which can be very well understood by people who understand technology.
Correct. And frankly, in the market, we have, scarcity of people who understand technology and understand law, both of the aspects, and cases increasing in terms of electricity law, construction contracts, intellectual property, media law. There is a lot to explore.
Absolutely. So do you have any specific instance or a memory which you think kind of helped you in early days of preparation? Because I'm sure the preparation for it must have been different than that of preparing for, let's say, an M.Tech or an MBA.
So see, in terms of, I'll say admission at IIT Kharagpur or a law or any other law school, it is different in terms of what we study for M.Tech and, other examinations at that point of time. But much of it is also related. Like for IIT Kharagpur entrance exam, they test basic sciences because it is a college which is related to intellectual property. For others, they might test the general aptitude, which also comes in other exams as well. But one thing which is very, very important in legal domain is understanding of English, understanding thing of language and writing. Writing becomes very, very important because mostly every examination that we undergo, they have a specific area where we have to, where our writing skills are tested. So that also becomes an important thing.
Yeah, absolutely. So Pragya, what I'll do now is that I'll get into a rapid fire round in which we'll ask you direct questions in which you'll have to give the answers of these questions in a direct and concise manner so that people can get exactly what they need, you know, when it comes to answering those questions specific to your field. Okay. So the first question that I have is that, is it a niche role or you think there are enough opportunities available in your sector for people to pursue their career in it?
So see, it's a rapid fire, but again, it depends on what kind of field you choose. It is a very diversified field and it is niche at the same time. So if you're specifically an electrical engineer and a computer science engineer, you'd like to work with those inventors, but then you can choose to work with artists, writers, poets, and so it's up to you.
Absolutely. I think that's a perfect answer. So what do you think is like the best part of working in your current role? Because somewhere people don't have a very like positive perception or let's say an exciting perception about working and the kind of industry you're working.
Correct. So the most exciting thing for me is, staying updated and exposure to the cutting edge technology what we have. It's like patent lawyers are one of the first people who get to know what technology advancement is happening around the world, because we are just out there with the technology and we are working with most of the technology people. So that is something which is very, very interesting.
Okay, so what does your like usual workday look like? So if not workday, at least a work week. So what kind of core work do you do on a regular basis?
So I'll tell you three things which we do on a daily basis. The first one is reading a lot, because we have to stay updated with the technology, we have to stay updated with law as well. So reading is the most important thing that we do on a daily basis. Second most important thing that we do on a daily basis is client interactions and client consultations. So we remain on the phone, we advise them, so advisory also becomes an important part of it. And third comes is the niche field, what is a specific skill set. For example, patent searchers will do searching, drafters will do drafting. The people who are working in litigation will go to court. So third is the niche field, what is specific to a person.
Okay. So so any resources that you think people should refer to? I mean, like online websites or blogs or books that you think that people should go to if they want to be like really successful in this career?
So there are a lot of, IP blogs where people can go and read about intellectual property. One of them is IP Watchdog, which I regularly followed as a student. Other is Patently.io, and in India, a very famous one, which is Spicy IP. Apart from this, there is World Intellectual Property Office, which is WIPO. And WIPO has, multiple free courses, paid courses, a combination of both, and lot of resource material, which is very, very helpful. Anybody who wants to learn IP can go to the website and read.
Okay, so that is WIPO. Okay, perfect. So what we will do is that we'll put that name maybe in our description so that people can go and refer to that. So the last question that I have, so any regular routine do you think that is absolutely important you are following and you think that has worked for you?
So see, I am a fan of, James Clear, the one who wrote Atomic Habits. So I believe in small continuous actions and 1% improvement. So it's just consistency which brings you wherever you want to be. So just be consistent. For example, if somebody wants to be a good lawyer, reading one judgment a day could be a good idea. If somebody wants to be in IP, reading one IP article a day could be a good one to start with. So just small actions, and I know it turns out very well.
I think that's a wonderful adaptation of what James Clear has written in his book Atomic Habits. In fact, I read that book almost like a couple of months back. Very, very inspiring, actually. So he talks about the regular stuff. He doesn't talk about something like miraculous will happen out of a sudden. Like take one small thing at a time, and then eventually you will see that it is kind of, you know, adding up exponentially. So I think so that's a wonderful learning, at least from your routine that you just talked about. So thank you. Thanks, Prigya, for joining us in this episode. To our listeners and viewers, if they want to connect with Prigya regarding any advice or anything that is related to intellectual property rights, IPR, so you can connect with her on her LinkedIn, or you can visit on her website. We'll put the link of that website on the description of this video.
If you have any specific questions about IPR you want to ask, put them in comment box. We will collate all these questions, get them answered, post their replies against each comment posted. So if you like this video, please check out all the other videos in the channel too. Thank you for watching.